fun. We're getting better. We're paying attention to our details. And, you know, like you said, we're trying to be one of the best of the best. So just out here competing, trying to get better. Our expectation is to win it. You know what I'm saying? That's what we come in, you know, expecting. That's how we prepare. You know what I'm saying? We're not making no excuses, no comfort seeking. It don't matter, you know, who's out there. We're going to go out there trying to win, trying to dominate.
It's nothing new. I feel like, you know, people always say, like, you know, oh, you got so much pressure on you. I'm like, man, it's not pressure. I see it as opportunity. You know what I mean? It's all opportunity for me to, you know, that other people might not have. So, you know, I embrace all of it, man. I love the challenges that, you know, that people give for me, you know, who's last in the run game, you know. So, like, I love the challenges of, you know, okay, we're going to draft a running back when people are saying, oh, don't draft a running back, you know. And it's like, you know, to overcome all this and, like, you know, and to prove all the people wrong, you know, it's a blessing, man. It's opportunity. That's what I see it. No pressure at all.
Being able to come back here was probably one of the biggest, you know, decisions that I'd made, you know, coming back on a one-year deal to play with the Steelers, but mainly because of Ben, knowing that he can give me the ball, knowing that we can make plays together, and knowing that we have that chemistry already.
Okay, things are looking up for the Steelers. Not the best end to the season. Of course, starting undefeated. And then, woof, did not work out. Let's take a look at other wide receivers. Speaking of Juju, they're in the AFC North. Do the Steelers, Pittsburgh, have the best wide receiver core in this division? As you guys size it up here, is it somebody else, Riggs?
How about the Bengals? Can I go there?
Let's go!
I know it's a little premature. I know we've been hyping the Bengals a lot this offseason with Joe Burrow returning, but everything I'm hearing from training camp is that these three guys are electric. It's not just Tyler Boyd. It's not just T. Higgins, who had good seasons last year. But now you throw in Ja'Marr Chase, who is a top five pick and universally considered one of the biggest playmakers in this rookie class. Mm. Throw in Burrow, throw in Brian Callahan and Zach Taylor's offense, and we could be looking at, I'm not pairing him for Super Bowl. I don't even think they're a playoff team yet. I don't. I think this team is going to light it up offensively, though, and I think these three wide receivers are going to be a problem, not only for the AFC North, but for the rest of the league. I know that these other guys have accomplished a lot. I can't trust Odell and Jarvis are going to be on the field every week. I don't know what we're getting from Pittsburgh after the way that season ended. And the Ravens receiving core has a lot to show me.
Mm-hmm.
These guys are all three studs. And Boyd is maybe the most underrated of all three. I'm going Bengals.
Wow.
A shocker.
Okay.
I like it.
I like that. You can't get mad at that. I haven't seen it yet. I want to see it pieced together, especially with Ja'Marr Chase being out there for the first time with, of course, T. Higgins and Boyd. But, you know, I'll say yes. They are. I don't believe that the receiver corps for the Steelers get enough credit. Juju Smith-Schuster is a guy that gave us 90 catches, and we act like he was just some bum struggling to find a free agent deal, which was crazy to me because I don't understand how you could put up 90 catches in a season, leave into free agency completely healthy, and then not land one of those $50 or $60 million deals.
Talk your talk, Nate.
But I will say this, though. I would love to see that gap between targets and catches close because they throw a lot of balls downfield. There's a lot of incompletions and drops. They can be more consistent. But I will say they are the best overall unit. Just like Peter said, the Ravens, more of a run team. We got to see Odell Beckham back healthy now with the Browns.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, you have the Bengals who are just very young and they haven't pieced together on field yet.
Agreed. I think the answer is none of them. Like, that they're all TBD. But I would just say over the weekend, we saw this incredible collection of Steelers greats and all these legendary icons of Pittsburgh and so much respect and gravitas. These three Steelers receivers all in their own way got clowned last year. They were literally the butt of jokes. People were making fun of them. Juju, Nate, we know the reason he didn't get that deal, maybe because people thought he was a clown. Like, I mean that. Like, he took a lot of heat for the stuff he did. People would rather pay Kenny Golladay or Corey Davis than Juju Smith-Schuster. Deontay Johnson was a running punchline because he couldn't catch anything and would drop everything. And then Chase Claypool, after they got destroyed by the Browns, went online and took shots at the Browns. So I don't know if they're the best. They should all be the most motivated because all three of these guys got made fun of, and Steelers don't get made fun of. It's not what you do as a company or as a team or as a program, whatever you want to call it. They have a lot to prove, all three of them.
Got Sean O'Hara, Mike Garofolo from the Ravens coming up. Giardi is joining us. He is, of course, with the Patriots up there in New England ahead of their preseason games. They welcome the Washington football team to town. We have reporters and insiders all across the map. We'll be talking about this. By the way, Ryan Tannehill, Derek.